I'm Anthony Hartman. I'm 12 years old and I like building stuff, especially if it can help a problem that's in the world, like we have right now in this pandemic. This is my new invention. It's an automated breathing support device that I made when we were all stuck at home during COVID.
That is Winnetka native Anthony Hartman showing off the working ventilator he built out of Legos. He submitted the idea to Kids Idea Tank. It's a summer entrepreneur competition, kind of like Shark Tank for kids. Mm-hmm. The winners are going to be announced next month, but he's a finalist.
Yeah. Anthony joins us this morning to tell us all about his invention. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, this is remarkable. Tell us what it does and how it works.
So the ventilator 2020 uses a manual pump bag, which would normally be like pumped by hand by squeezing and releasing. This has a lot of inconsistencies because the human can only be so consistent. However, by adding motors that are here and here that compress the bag and release it on a timely manner, that eliminates all those inconsistencies.
Can you show us how it works? Does it just turn on?
Yeah, sure. So
all right,
when you turn it on, what happens is the motors drive pinion, rack and pinion gears to push in and out.
Wow.
And it compresses this.
How did you figure out how to do this?
So I was a part of a school robotics team for Lego. It was affiliated with FLL. So FLL is the first Lego league. So I did a lot of, I was one of the head engineers for the robotics team. So I built a lot of robots out of Legos and all those things. So I wanted to combine my skill with Legos with my want to help people and help things.
This
so
is,
I made that.
Anthony, this is just amazing. I'm sure your parents are so proud of you. I'm just amazed because the only Legos I can put together are the ones that give you that book page by page. So you're the one who's actually, once you're done with that, you're taking it apart and using those Legos to build something you're creating, right?
Yeah.
That's unbelievable. I mean, so you're a finalist in this competition, right?
So I was a finalist last year, and then the year before that, I partnered with two of my friends who approached me with an idea, and the first year that Idea Tank was a thing, we were able to win the Idea Tank. But last year I was a finalist. This year, they haven't announced any finalists yet.
Oh, so is this ventilator is up for an award this year? You don't know if you're a finalist yet.
This ventilator was up for an award last year.
Ah.
So what? It's not medically up to code, but I would think if you had trouble breathing, that would be a code enough for me. is there something more you have to do to it?
Not really. You can see like the test lung pumping in and out. The only thing that would happen is right here, there is area for a oxygen tube as well as a reservoir bag. So that would
Larry.
Come from like the hospital.
Well, I was going to
suggest
that,
Anthony.
But it's a good thing
that.
You figured that out.
You got to talk down to Larry. He doesn't quite get it. What do you want to be when you grow up, Anthony?
I want to try to be a mechanical engineer, and what would be amazing is if I would be able to like do a co-op or something with the YouTuber Mark Rober.
With who?
The YouTuber Mark Rober.
Oh.
Oh, he's my favorite YouTuber. So yeah, good. Good luck. You've already accomplished more at 12 than most of us have as adults.
You're going places, Anthony.
Yeah,
congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for joining us. Wow. Dang it, we have got to stop talking to such smart kids. It's really, it's
depressing.
Just making me feel bad about myself every day.
Well, still a couple years left to turn it around.
I don't know. Larry, I think that ship has sailed for us. Oh, man. Up next, the organization behind the Golden Globes is facing new pressure over